Point.
All right, so we're live, it seems. It's gonna be Luminosity Gaming taking on Team Liquid. The knife round is going. CT side, obviously, something that both teams want to fight for. And I mean, I'm not keeping track of knife rounds, unfortunately. I like to see who goes where and wins what, but I'm sure both teams wanting to take the more advantageous CT side. So they'll just jockey around, and honestly, this game is gonna be pretty close. I think it'll be pretty close with how Liquid played yesterday, at least on their CT half. If Liquid get this CT to start, which it seems like they are, LG might be in for a little bit of trouble. And albeit that was on Overpass yesterday, but who knows? Oh, Piff.
Showing some moves.
Yeah, he's got the little underneath. Jumping on top of him, Raining Man. Raining Man strat. Ah, there you go. Nitro gets it, okay. That was almost scary.
Some clever plays. So they get to start off on that CT side. It's going to be a lot of work for Luminosity to break into that A bomb site, as I said, and Adren, once he gets that up in middle, that's a spot that he's been very effective in the past. So, tall task ahead of Luminosity here.
We'll be seeing him look to his boost more than likely, or just going through the smoke shot. Like there's normal times where Liquid will just smoke up towards the mid main and then just kind of tap away because the T's would sometimes be reckless and push through it. So we'll see. For now, the bomb just scurries its way over to B, and it seems that I don't want to see slow T play with the bomb over to B, but they're going to do it. They're going to bring it back towards main and just sit there and wait for their own steps. And this is where Desi just pushed through last time and just tapped away and wrecked the Temple Storm side. But LG a little bit better than that, and we'll see. Peter, is going to be making a lot of noise here towards this A site with Anger, too, jumping around and pulling a Roka and Squeaky.
Yeah, Anger's going to be in that door a lot. He's kind of their lurker on this map, lurking the door and lurking into mid. So they take away his fragging ability, and they put it to a use in a different situation. But now here comes the creep into B, and Elise is going to spot one. Misses the shot on the crack, but he falls back towards a headshot angle. He's able to get one jump and a second one. Nice shots from Elise. Eventually gets taken out, but he's done good damage. And that's the bomb over at B, and they've cleaned out A. So it's going to be a 3-on-1 retake, and A2Z is just waiting for his teammates to join in.
I thought he was like lagged or something. He's like on the wall. But Lex is going to go into a pretty defensive position in B main, it seems. Leaving the site, he's made those shots, and yeah, he's just gone. Jumping down, Nitro gets the headshot, and Liquid take the first round. That was all off of Liege, that hold, that headshot.
Yeah, especially with his teammate rotating off. He was all alone there, and he had to hit those shots, and he absolutely did. So very nicely done by him. Nitro as well with 2 kills that round. They cleaned up that kind of a little bit of an A, that fake. There was just 2 players that came into that A bomb, so they cleaned that up very, very quickly.
And, all right, we'll see them pick up, actually, an M4, Fugly, that's a pretty aggressive buy. But the Famas's nades, should see some SMGs, and we'll be good to go. So Luminosity looking to start at possibly, you know, a 3-0 start for Liquid, but Tech9 rushes have done some miraculous things in the past, and they still can.
They have 3 Molotovs, so this is, you know, a planned execution on this A for their eco. They're going to molly off, you know, quad, they're going to molly off the fence, and they might even molly off, you know, forklift or the bomb site. But it's, I wouldn't say completely countered, but very, very safe setup from Liquid playing very far back. Fugly and Adren both on the highway with Nitro at the truck, so these Molotovs aren't going to do much, but this setup should allow them to get a second round plant.
Okay. So flashes, smokes, mollies out like you said, and here we go. They're just ready to execute it to the site. They end up blinding Lex just a little bit too as soon as he opens the squeaky door, but they're just gonna shoot through these smokes. Oh man, Anger gets put down pretty low too. Adren finds a kill. They push through their own smoke, and Nitro from Truck, man, he's able to do some serious damage, but the bomb is gonna go down as Flom gets it out, and no deaths at least to come out from the Liquid side. Maybe just gonna be a flawless round, but the bomb plant was what Luminosity wanted, and we'll see that buy next round, but they want to inflict some eco damage. Flom is still trying to peek here with this Tech9. They haven't pushed in just yet. They want to use these nades. Peter is going to find himself a Liege. He gets an M4 in his hand, and this is a pretty dangerous situation for him. But as soon as he peeks, he meets A2Z, and the diffuse should come out, and minimal casualties for Liquid.
Yeah, and very well done by Liquid, especially, you know, knowing that they're going to be giving up that plant, just playing for the retake, getting some kills on the way in. And, you know, even though the plant got down, that was a full investment by Luminosity Armor. That was so many mollies and nades, Tech9s and pistols. You know, getting a plant is nice, but it's not enough on that kind of a round. They wanted to get, you know, 2 or 3 kills there to at least make that worth it.
Oh, yeah, they're not going for the buy round. I don't know why I said that, but they picked the pistol armor last round. Just kidding. If they wanted to go for the buy round, they would full save, but still trying to win. But the next gun round is going to be next round, and this is going to be a flat-out rush. They pick up some deagles. They actually pick up triple deagle and 2 P250s. So again, looking for that eco damage. They're actually putting Pith in a That spot. Alige! Woo! Anger, if only he could see what we saw. Actually tags him down pretty low.
Yeah, those deagle hits are no joke, but the nade response pretty much equalizes it. And he's still playing very aggressive at this box, and he's got A2Z. They're kind of in a bait-and-switch position.
Oh, Anger, he actually gets the headshot onto A2Z, and then a Dren actually falls to Lex's deagle. So now we're in a 4-on-3, and Liquid... Oh, Pith! Just one-tapping Fugly down. Alicia's on the flank. This is where the round could turn around, though. If Alicia can pick off one or two more, they want to peek in. Oh, but Pith... gets his
Nitro's
second.
Not going to clear this corner. Oh, he does. Lee swings around. Lex isn't able to get the kill. So, one on two situation with Nitro.
He could pick up that M4. Pith should be able to get that. No, he's going to stick with the deagle for now. There's an M4 right in front he could go for. That's A2Zs. And Nitro, this is a tough position to be in. Luminosity may have just thrown a huge wrench into the plans of Liquid. That's a phenomenal eco, but Nitro going to look for the clutch. It's the player you like to highlight a lot. This is his time to shine, but Pith, this is a perfect angle from the peak, and he does.
Jeez.
What a one tap. And now, with a triple kill on an eco deagle naked by Luminosity, get their first round.
That was a smackdown. Those deagles were a real thing from Luminosity, and that was absolutely brutal. So they throw, they throw a wrench in the plans of Liquid, and it's gonna force an eco round here for them.
Everything was a deagle kill that round. That's insane. You don't get to see normally that work too well.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great gun for the one-shot kill, obviously. They just caught Liquid peeking to try and get those kills. So, I mean, it was just a bunch of very nice shots.
So Flash is coming in. Anger has that M4 from the last round, and he's a man that pretty much likes this gun a lot. But he's got to be careful he doesn't trade his life. There's a light of A2Z on the exchange. But all right, you know, this is just a display of Luminosity using Pith to their advantage, man. He is... coming in hot, and now we got Flom from short, and there you go. 3-on-2. This is still winnable for Liquid, though. Head armor for Fugly, and he's playing over towards B, and could look for a flank or just listen for the steps. They still haven't decided whether they want to go for the bomb yet.
Yeah, Fugly's in a pretty nice position. If they don't clear this, he could do a lot of damage, but there's a lot of time left on the clock, so Ali's just going to spot him out in the vents. Pith knows he did some damage, and you can see Anger with only 18 HP. Fugly looks the wrong way at the wrong time, and Anger's able to take him out. That's a huge kill for him, so they clear out that B bomb site.
And Elige is on the save.
Yeah, and he might be able to find a gun somewhere. They got two kills. He does have an AK in his hands already, yeah. So now it's all up to whether LG wants to hunt him down and take this out of his hands.
I would think they don't want to risk losing their own guns, but they built up a little bit of bank, so could go for it. Seems that they'll send Pith out. Kind of trust him to do his own thing there. Oh, he's looking for the AWP. Oh, there was an AWP that round, actually. I didn't even see that.
Yeah, he must have got taken out without really getting into the action, but...
Oh, that's Peters, okay.
This save from Alige is going to be actually crucial, because he's going to be able to drop it to A2Z or Adren. And they could force buy here if they wanted to.
Will they? That's the real question. They gotta be talking about it, like, do we really want to force this little Liege kind of buy armor and kind of protect him?
It's a tough decision this early on, but, you know, it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world, and it looks like they are actually just gonna save up, try and get an eco win of their own. This save here just kind of says to me that they want to have an AWP in Adren's hands going forward.
Alright, so, aggressive play, more than likely. They sent actually three over to B, only one to play A, and one up mid, so... they're not going to scout anything out of B, and this A take from LG should come in phenomenally. No one even holding the site. Fugly's going to be pushed up aggressively on highway, and yeah, this is going to be a quick A take. Flash is coming in, that's going to be heard. Fugly's going to make the call, and the rest of the CTs from Liquid, they're going to be on a long, hard flank. Well, Lex is getting tagged through the smoke right now. He's going to be a little frustrated by that. The Deagle, though, working out phenomenally for Fugly, and I mean, no one's died yet. Never mind, just kidding. Fugly dies as he pushes up.
Yeah, and I'd like to see, I don't know how much they're going to commit to this. Alige is just going for exit kills with that AK, so he wants to keep that in his hands, and the rest of them might just try and find one kill as they exit the bomb site. But Adren, even if he wants to afford off with armor, Nitro gets a kill. Adren's just going to fall off as well and maybe try and grab an exit a gun when Alige kills one, but he wants to save that armor for the AWP next round.
Yeah, that's the big thing, but A2Z can't find much. They're going to retreat directly into Alige, who actually picks up one, but Peter responds, the AK is gone. And now Adren gonna push himself up, and he's gonna go down as well. So Peter survives just barely, and Luminosity, that's quick three in a row on their T side. And Liquid, this is a big buy run for them. They need to win this one out. And Adren needs it AWP. Nitro actually buys it for him too, so. This is a huge investment for Liquid.
Right, but they have a good buy. I mean, they don't have head armor, would not a big deal against an AWP and AK-47s, but they have the utility behind it. The only thing they're really lacking on is a kit. They have one on a Liege, but that's it. So he's going to be very important in terms of his positioning. And they do take that mid control. They get a Liege up close to prevent any rush. They get him in events. It gets mollied out immediately. And that early of a molly should signal that, that there's going to be pressure put onto this B site very, very quickly. Adren's the only one here with the AWP.
He missed.
Gets blind. He misses the first shot, but he takes off the head of Adren, takes his time before the smoke plumes, and it's going to be a retake out of this B bomb site.
Well, there you have it. That was a good wait. He missed the first one, unfortunately, but there we have it. Elige on the flank, able to stop them. He's in checkers, just juking and jiving, finds himself a double kill, but the plant's going to come out from Luminosity, and Lex with Pith, this is a duo that could make this work, but it's going to be so tough. Going to get Molly. Nades come out, but Pith finds the first one onto A2Z. Is the Swedish powerhouse going to be enough? He gets a double, but can't find the triple. Adren peeking with the AWP. Lex going to delay. Adren's going to push out, get headshot immediately. Lex, can he get the double? No. So the defuse will come out, and Liquid salvage that round.
Yeah, but Pith almost with some magical shots. If he gets Adren, that's such a scary situation. Nicely done by him, but even to do the damage there at the end of the round, because that was looking like a pretty clean sweep retake by Liquid, and that's just the positioning that, that holding mid provides you as CT with a player in vents like that. Able to get over there so quickly, Elise dropping and getting two crucial frags, but their economy is still so incredibly fragile after losing three players there.
Boy, so if they lose this, economy's gonna break, and Luminosity could find a few rounds in a row, so. Smoke's over to mid. Gonna keep their attention drawn, and I mean honestly, like Liquid, they're showing phenomenal play, but this isn't like their CT side on overpass for sure. Like they're not running away with it right now. Luminosity is just really putting on the heat. So Pith jumps up, that nade lands right on top of Adren's head. He's dropped to half. Oh.
Yeah, they've done a more passive mid setup here, and Adren's just looking for the head of Pith, but he should be able to tell to his team that they're up, they're in highway, he can't cover it, and that's exactly where Peter was trying to find a pick with his AWP. He's up on the box looking towards quad, so defense over there has to be very careful.
And Flom's just lurking at B, man. He wants to see if anybody's going to push to go for that flank, and Liquid aren't biting. And again, we got Anger. Look at this. Opening squeaky door, making some noise. And doing his team proud, look at this. He just jumps back and forth. He's not even spraying the door, neither is Liquid, though, but it's always going to keep one or two in that site, and they just execute straight out of the vents, and they take down a Liege, and then Anger finally lurks out, but Nitro was ready and waiting. Lex finds another kill. A2Z, he's caught in a fire and a flash, and he's just dead. In upper, Adren finds the shot, takes down Peter. He's going to get caught looking the wrong way. So the bomb now going to go down. 2-on-3, retake. Nitro and Fugly. This is the duo that we like to see at A site. The nade hitting Fugly in the face, though. What do we got? Flom waiting at events. Pop flash comes in. Flom not blinded, though, turns at the correct spot. But Nitro still going to push in, gets the headshot. Looking for some more possibly here in B main, but Pith holding. Nitro at 25 health. What do we got? Pith goes down to Lex, and the duo actually working out well. They know how to play their spots, and they're making the calls correctly.
Yeah, playing very, very patiently in the site, not overextending, not giving any kills before they... I mean, the Liquid players were forced to commit to that retake before anyone from Luminosity really showed themselves, so a nice round there from Luminosity, and they've completely avoided this A bomb site, basically. They've been taking mid, they've been taking taking B as well. So staying away from that duo over at A.
Really avoiding that, so Luminosity, good hold, good take, and now we're back onto an actual full eco from Liquid, with just two P250 scattered out there, but alright, they're 5 stacked today. They really thought that an A take would come, and they're going to be unpleasantly surprised that there's nothing there, and this B bomb's like completely open, unbeknownst to Luminosity, but as soon as these nades fly out, they'll push in and see nothing, and be more than happy to take a free plan, and more than likely a free round. Or they can minimize the casualties at least, but alright, what can they get? Liquid, I believe, are looking to save guns for the next round too, but Elise on the flank gets caught out.
Yeah, they're just trying to get some exit kills, and Pith might give him one by pushing up here. He's going to pop flash his way through. He's going to spot Nitro, but Nitro swings around and grabs him with the pistol shot. Gets sprayed down through the smoke for his trouble. So damage really being done here. Even Adren gets spotted out. He has an AK. He might just want to throw that over to Fugly and shoot it to him because he's not getting out.
He tries to peek with it, though. Tries to get aggressive, man. Just can't do it. And then Fugly, he's stuck at CT, and Only one loss for Luminosity, so they're keeping the round strong here. They clean up the last kill. And now they put themselves at 5-3. So Luminosity haven't lost a round since Liquid picked up the first three.
Yeah, but it's more than likely going to be another save out of Liquid, a double save here. So This is going to give Luminosity a little bit of a cushion, not only in their economy, but in the round scores. Oh no, it's going to be a force buy. Okay, really? So they're not going for that AWP. They pick up the Phobos, even in a Bison on Fugly.
Are you sure? And once again, do you like this pickup?
Again, only one kit. No, not this early, but it's not the end of the world. I mean, it's just going to put some strain on them. If they can't manage to win this one, their economy is going to be very... It's going to be very awkward buys for them for the rest of this half.
Okay. So, again, they're going to actually attempt to break through Nitro and Fugly. Nitro hugging the wall next to Squeaky. The door is open. He actually closes it this time, though. Anger's like, no, I'm going to leave the door open. And Smokes come in. Incendiaries, flashes, all galore. How do they get into the site? Nitro's still holding close to the door. He's actually burning a little bit there. Getting sprayed through. Anger's able to get the kill. Huge way to start that round, and...
And no one's even committed to this hit yet, so they just basically get a pick for free. They find Fugly, a nice entry by Pith. He's going to get a second one as Adren comes through the smoke. A beautiful execution, a beautiful take by Luminosity. Very patient as the smokes and the Molotovs come out. No one even really leaving A main until they got that first pick.
Yep, so A2Z going to save his M4, or try to. I believe he's going to get hunted out here. He hears Lex coming. Does Lex respond fast enough? No, he does not. A2Z will at least get the exit there, but now his position's... Kind of giving up, and he's going to get pinched super hard. And as he peeks, he gets Pith. Can he get Anger? No, he cannot. So he did a little bit of damage, but that's going to put Liquid on another eco.
Yep, and then they'll be able to... It should be a full buy in the next round. But Luminosity came in looking very, very sharp on this map. That B execute they had early on... that they ended up losing the round, but it was very cool. It was a very fast Molotov into the vents, and then they hit B super quickly just to prevent anyone from being effective in vents, and then that A hit was just was really, really nice.
Yeah, the A hit executed not phenomenally. Peter's going to get up here onto the boost again, not spot on anything, and this time the eco from Liquid is going to be stacked at B. So we'll see potentially another just near perfect read from the LG side. Everybody pushing out from Liquid right now. Steps being made. Flom finds one. Can he get a second? No. A2Z a little too quick with the P250. And highway control is just on the Luminosity side. Adren trying to tap through the smoke. He gives up his own spot, though. And they're boosting up the vent. They're really trying to catch them off guard here. The bomb has not aggressed into any site. They're actually double boosting into the vent here. They get behind Peter and take him down. He's going to be frustrated by that. And then Lex rushes in, almost dying himself. So now it's actually a 3-on-3, and... The A site, LG just don't know. They're like, this is open? Where are they? They stacked B, and finally they get into it.
Yeah, they know now, and Pith's going to get this bomb planted. Anger's going to stay in A main. He's even going to smoke things off, so... Pith has to make sure he doesn't go down too early with Anger this far away. It is planted for him.
Okay, so Nitro, 18 health, no armor, pushing up with this AWP. There's no one playing A main anymore. Anger's actually kind of hiding behind the smoke. Pith, Anger going huge. It's all up to A2Z, the stand-in. Can he make it work? He tries to flick, but no, he can't out-duel Anger. So that round almost lost for LG, but
they pulled together. Yeah, Anger getting smoked off and coming through it, and then him and Pith working together. Pith using that smoke in the bomb site that Anger threw wonderfully to be able to spot the angles and find some one-on-one battles. So very good recovery in that round, and now we have this this full buy out of Liquid. They've got the no kits though, so that's more of a trouble. They've had really light kits this entire half, so even their full buys are a little bit light on some of the utility. Adren's gonna drop and get that quick peek through the angle with the AWP, but Anger's pushing up very aggressively, looking towards spawn. Adren gets him as well, and this is a fully committed B attack at the moment.
That's the Adren we're used to seeing, but that time he gets mowed down afterwards. Trying to push into the site though, A2Z had that molly for some help. Flom gets dinked, gets shot in the back, and now it's up to Peter. The off pickup for this team. Can he make this clutch happen? He's covering his back, the bombs drop towards CT spawn, and he's in a 1-on-2. He's got about a minute to work with too. So, I mean, this is going to be very tough. He dropped his AWP as well. Like, that's interesting to see that he wants to play this one out with a rifle. He's going to come behind. He went up Z. They have no idea.
Ooh. Yeah, well, Nitro might get picked off not looking, but Fugly's going to be able to turn around and have a really interesting angle that Peter might not be ready for.
Oh, Peter's going to go upper instead.
No, that's a bummer. It was a really good play, and obviously that's a 50-50 decision there. It's just that could have been very promising. So 30 seconds, he's going to be forced to drop. They're going to hear it. He's going to go for Nitro.
He Nitro.
Does get that kill, but he's not ready for Fugly, who drops him.
You know, had that situation be where Peter peeks out, if he peeked wide, he would have saw both of them and probably won that round, but that's just hypotheticals. And either way, Liquid get the rounds, and that's definitely needed. This CT side for them is not going well, though. Like, this is not what they wanted, for sure.
No, they need to string together here some more. Losing this round would just be absolutely brutal. To get your economy reset for a second time and a half, that's just so tough.
They're boosting up, too. Looking over the smoke, trying to get Adrenaline off-peak shot, and not going to find anything. Everybody's pushing up A main. And now they're going to be letting Anger push out here towards Squeaky. A2Z can't find anything. With the FAMAS, though, he finds a quick kill at Forklift. They're just trading back and forth. A burn kill actually comes in at the Nitro, and planted into the site, 3-on-3. They're gonna go for it. Liquid cannot afford to save here. They need these rounds so desperately.
And Adrenaline truck. Luminosity is being so aggressive, knowing that the equipment for Liquid is light, not having smokes like they'd want in counter flashes. Anger wins that battle. One coming up highway, that's Fugly. Adren also with the AWP. He's forced out of his position and gets picked off, so it's down to this 2-on-2, Flom and Peter. Flom very low HP. Fugly takes him out. He's able to drop down onto Peter, shoot straight down on his head, but no kits.
No kit.
They've got to pick it up in quad. They've got to pick it up in quad here.
This is going to be close. He's got it. He's got it. Yeah. Okay, so Liquid come close on that rounds, and Fugly and Adren, great retake. HZ as well, picking up one kill before they entered, and just the trades going favorably for Liquid that time.
Yeah, and LG, what I was trying to say was they're being so smart. They know they have the economy of Liquid low, and they know that they're going to be light on counter flashes and counter mollies to like really delay those A hits. So just coming through the smoke when Liquid's not expecting it, almost able to make that one work.
So close, but yet so far, and this is the string of rounds that Liquid needs, but we'll see. Peter going aggressive up mid with that AWP, gets smoked off and tries to blind fire. And, I mean, Luminosity already picked up enough rounds here on the T side. They're just looking to stack up a little bit more. And their CT side is going to be pretty scary, honestly. So, Anger again doing his thing. Finds the quick shot out from Squeaky. Looking for some more. The reaction shot isn't there onto Nitro, though. So they force him back into sight. He gives up his quad spot. And the way they're jockeying for the positioning right now, it seems that... Oh, actually, I thought they were going to bring an A. Never mind. They kind of back off.
They have Peter over here, though. He throws a little bit of a distraction, a little bit of a smoke. Yeah, they are going to fall back towards B. Or mid, actually. Lex is coming up towards mid. Allegia's in the vents. He's playing in the vents to cover both B and mid, and that AWP is from Adren is going to scare him away from middle a little bit, so it's just going to be Peter trying to win this battle. And then deciding not to peek. So it's just going to be this four-man hit onto B. It's A2Z. He's all alone for quite some time. Any kind of rotation, it's just going to be Allegia coming out of vents.
Oh, boy. So Allegia on a hard flank position, or just an arch drop position. Like, if he flashes out right now, he'll probably blind quite a few of them. There's the flash. There you go, but they still push in. Pith goes big with the Galil. Allegia can only find one, and then Flob's Deagle kills him off. So now we're in a 2-on-3 post-plant, and Liquid, this is going to be a tough retake. B-site, very hard to get into. A lot of good angles.
Nitro's on a big flank, though, and Flom, I believe, is behind that box. He is. It's a little confused, so they're not giving it to him. Not giving him any peeks or any information to find. He does spam one, but he can't go through. He finds Pith. They didn't call it out, and he wasn't paying attention. Didn't look. Nitro actually gets two, so a great job from him. Now it's all on Anger. He's got
an AWP. Is he going to stick this?
15 HP.
He can he get him? Stick it. Oh, he missed!
Oh, Flom misses the shots. Turned around to his back, and it just doesn't hit. So Flom loses a pretty easy one-on-one with Adren sticking the bomb, and that's huge for Team Liquid. Something going their way.
That crouching hitbox, man. It's pretty annoying.
Last night, none of the clutches went their way, and tonight they get one of their own to make up for it.
There you go. Carrying a little bit of luck there, but 6-7. Team Liquid still need to win out here to have a good shot at their T side to bring it back. And LG, they salvaged up that AWP at least for Peter, so that was one thing that was a win for them. And again, Anger, look at this. He's done it consistently just about every round so far.
Yeah, this seems like it's going to be another very, very aggressive A execute. This time, I mean, they're still a little bit light on counter flashes and nades like they'd want to over at the A bomb site, but they're forcing it back. This time, Luminosity doesn't want to run through that smoke.
So, Elige covering up mid. They're going to commit. They have the smokes and flashes ready to go. Anger's still just toying with them on Squeaky. And I like how Team Liquid really aren't overcommitting. They're just staying in their spots and listening for these smokes and flashes, seeing as to how it's just become pretty much like clockwork for Luminosity. So.
Yeah, but they fall off this. Yeah. They're waiting for some kind of peek. Peter wants to find someone who's looking for information. Hasn't been able to find it quite yet. He might get it onto Nitro, but being very patient in quad. And everyone rotated off, and now they're coming right back for the execute.
All right, so they kind of faked it a little bit, but coming right back like you said. So nades and flashes are out, Nitro spamming away. Anger and PDR going so big. Then Anger getting a collateral kill through his own teammate, the Lex. A2Z can't hold the site by himself, and Adrenaline this AWP. He's playing truck. I'm surprised he's not just backing off and trying to save, but yeah, this is going to be Luminosity's 8th round. That was just phenomenal. They delayed it out and just completely caught them off guard and blew them away.
Yeah, well Peter actually found a blind kill. He was completely blind and just timed it perfectly when Nitro peeked from quad boxes, so a little bit fortunate there. That really collapsed the defense, so Adren's very dead eventually, and it's going to be right now. Lex just crouches under the crosshair and slides up. He even salvages the AWP, or no, actually, he did not. Looked like he did. So, a nice round from Luminosity is going to put him up 8-6.
They don't need to salvage, man.
And the economy for Liquid's broken once again, so this is going to be another armor pistol buy.
Full buy off the nades, get whatever, and yeah, it should look like a 9-6 for Luminosity, I gotta say. This is working out really well for them. Anger and Pythe, really just coming up big. 13-9, 14-8, KDA's looking really good.
It's Pythe.
Pythe, okay. I was saying it correctly, I don't know why I thought otherwise, but maybe we see an aggressive play here from Nitro towards Squeaky, trying to take down Adren. Coordinate the flash, not full blinds, Anger! There you go, that's what you needed! That was a really well-executed play, but trying to go for the peaks here, Fugly, gonna end up losing out Nitro, but trading his life for Lex, and now Peter pushing up here towards that short, gets the shot, but gets dinked! So now we're in a 3-on-3 again, the 5-7's going to town, though. Adren and Elige going big. Now it's 1-on-3, Flom. Having a bit of a tough time now, but he's able to pick up two, and 1-on-3 against A2Z, the stand-in. He's gonna look to make this happen, Flom faking it, but A2Z is gonna be able to clutch it out. So Liquid are gonna be reluctant to get that round.
Yeah, that's a good round to get there for Team Liquid right at the end, and that's all of a sudden keeping it close and giving themselves a chance, not getting blown out. There was some time, I mean, Team Liquid really clawed their way into that 7 rounds, because there were some times at the, you know, early on in the half and even in the middle portions where it was starting to look a little bit scary for them.
So now we get to see Luminosity on defense. Their aggression was so good. I mean, I expected nothing but more aggression from Anger. Like, I'm sure he'll push Squeaky, I'm sure he'll do things towards B main, and Peter should be the man to control mid. Pith, I think he's been pretty silent. Even though he's been picking up these kills, like, I haven't seen too many crazy plays out of him, just like kind of going for good flanks and going with flashes and such. Just going with the flow.
Well, except for that eco round of the
deagle. Yeah, the one eco round.
Absolutely, you know, insane. So
the three deagles.
You could just see when he's in those clutch situations, he just excels in them. He's just got so much. His game sense is just kind of. It seems at times that it's just miles above some of his opponents, and he just excels in them. But here, this is going to be Liquid and another T-side, and they've been struggling with these slower strats on their T-side, and we'll just see what they have in store and how they're going to take that mid-control, because actually at CT, I was surprised at, you know, they put a leash in events, but they didn't really have any holding for middle.
This thing can do so much here. Boom, there you go. Oh, it doesn't do much. What? Oh.
Yeah, a little bit too far.
Damn. I look like it should have been like a 50 damage nade, if anything, but all right. LG already started with a bit of an advantage after that, and they're going for a delayed kind of boost play. Looking for pushers, doing what they can to wear down the clock and keep LG guessing. LG aren't going to pull an elevate, though. They're not that aggressive to where they'll just kind of rush out and peek just to make sure. So, Adren pushing up mid. Liquid have full control of that. Seems that Luminosity giving up that, and I'm really surprised they did, because now they're going up Z, and they're going to go straight towards CT, and they find Flom, who can't really do much. He lights one up, and that's about it, but shot in the back, Pith gets the headshot, and coming into this B site, Lex is holding in checkers, Getting a good flash out. He sees one. He's going to try to tap down with the Nitro. Gets the headshot. The plant's going to come in at least. He's looking for Fugly and BMA, and that's going to be the call for Anger while Anger fights out A2Z. Peter's going to push into the site, and Anger goes down to Fugly. Leash is lit. He's going to rush him down with the help of that pop flash, and who has a kit? Anybody have a kit? Yeah, there's one kit. That round's over.
Really, really nice round from Lex there. Is getting that kill in checkers and just staying alive and keeping them funneled. You kept one player outside B completely, and one player after the plant just had to stay in the site. So Lex with a very nice round after Flom falls. Almost a scary situation and an interesting strategy. You don't see that too often because, you know, when you get into CT spawn, you just have there's a long passageway where you're from truck down where your back is just completely exposed at long range. So almost executed very, very well by Liquid there.
So 9-7, gonna be the buy around Liquid. No armor, just pistols actually to come out from them.
Well, they got the plant, so it's gonna be a third round buy.
Yeah, just full save. So let's see. Coming up with Squeaky, smokes out, and it's gonna be the quick surprise play attempt, but Pithman, reading the situation, gets the triple. Anger's gonna spot the man up on jump. Adrenaline finds one surprise kill, but that's it. So a cheeky play, doesn't work out, and now we'll see the AKs this round, which really could upset a lot of balance that LG had built up. A lot of momentum. But this is a full buy, so they'd end up having to save about two more rounds afterwards.
Yeah, I'm gonna look for Nitro, who's a pretty strong entry fragger coming out of A, and Fugly as well, both of those guys. And Elige, actually, we haven't really said his name too much, but last season he was just an absolute monster for Elevate for most of the season before
triple
he
boost.
Transferred over. And yep, now they're gonna boost up, get out quickly. That's Elige, he gets sprayed down by Lex. Flom and Pith combined for another one. So it's getting shut down very, very early on. So many players in middle stopping Liquid from advancing anywhere.
But Fugly, he finds one. He's going to find a second as Lex pushes in late from the events. So, bomb's going to be moseyed on over to the B-bomb site. And what do we got? Flom, is he going to drop? The flash on the Fugly was perfect. Just didn't want to peek. The bomb's still holding in B-main. They're going to actually stop it. A2Z didn't want to push into the site. Upper wasn't clear. So now it's all left into Adren's hands. And it's not doable.
That attack, Fugly and A2Z just kind of stall out there in checkers and in the entranceway. They got two kills in that way from Fugly, and then they just kind of stall and give time for Flom to do that flank out the vents, give time for Anger and Pith to come over, so not taking advantage of the situation, and then they just get mowed down from behind. So nice play from Luminosity, and that's that three-man mid-control. What's even though they lose those players in B and that B bomb site is wide open for the taking, there's just such quick, fast rotates into the vents. You can see how worried the Liquid players were that there would be a player there, and that's why it stalled out.
So back onto the eco's Liquid go, want to get this plant, want to get the surprise factor. We got a deagle for Fugly, so maybe we're gonna pull some Pith-esque plays. So they'll lurk back, look for a pusher. Lex is gonna be the one to throw in a nade that does a crap ton of damage, but Fugly, there it is, the one deag onto Lex. So now they push into this B bomb site, but Flom is forced to hold this one out. Peter as well looking to peek with his AWP, Adren covering the flank, but it doesn't matter. They do go for a 2-for-2 trade. Never mind, Pith from upper just making this a more even situation. They at least get the bomb plant from the Liquid side, so they get some money, and they'll be able to buy next round, which is what they were looking for.
Yeah, but Luminosity is starting to run away with it, so these plants, I mean, it's great for this round, but they have to start winning them now, or it's going to be big, big trouble. And this is starting to look like going to be a solid win for Luminosity, and I was interested seeing them, how slow they played on other maps yesterday. We talked about that a lot, but how fast they went over for that mid control very, very early on and just kind of got mowed down. They weren't expecting that. So now they're going to slow things down again, especially with the Dren's AWP. They want to give him a chance to find a pick somewhere to use that AWP effectively and give him time to find an opening for him.
All right, well, the Dren's AWP going to come into effect. It seems that he's going to actually be playing that one A main looking for a pusher, and they're not going to find much.
A clever jump from Adren actually boots out the op shot from Peter.
Yeah, very, very sneaky plays. Very crafty plays, not sneaky, but over here towards Squeaky Nitro pulling the Anger. He sprays through and actually hits Peter pretty hard, but Peter goes for the re-peek on Adren in A main and just absolutely obliterates him there.
Yeah, what a shot from Peter. That was actually really, really nice. A small crack to hit. Manages it perfectly.
So we got the smokes, re-smokes coming in, flashes as well. The bomb still yet to be spotted, but the spray down onto Elige, man, put him to 48. And they're flashing up mid once again. They're still going for this mid control and invent Angerman with the help of the perfect flash. Yeah, he finds a double. He's going to end the round with a triple.
That was actually absolutely beautiful teamwork between Anger and Pith in that flash combination. And it was, once again, it was Anger in the vents, and you can see Team Liquid, they get out, and they want to go, but they know someone's in there, and they just stall out, and they're just staring at the vents, waiting for Anger to peek, but he's patiently waiting for that pop flash, so they give him, you know, a couple extra seconds to play it passively, and they get completely blind and mowed down. Very, very nice work from Luminosity so far.
They're looking on another level than Liquid right now, I gotta say. Definitely looking very coordinated. Anger going for an aggressive, like, there's another position to camp out the vents. But Liquid aren't going for anything too crazy. Playing it slow. Gonna be throwing up their nades and trying to execute into the A site. Not even a fake attempt. Just gonna be going raw into it. So flashbangs out. They're gonna push the Molly a little bit, get around it. But the counter flashbangs, man, working way too well for Team Luminosity. And Elise finds one at the pit, though. They jump up. Nitro finds Peter. Can they get this retake? Lex on a huge flank. This is the big position he can go for right now. He gets one. Flom got another. And it's up to Anger and Lex to clutch this one out. But Lex on the flank on the forklift, man. It's 2-on-2. Fugly with 4 health. There is no nade to get him out of quad. Fugly peeks, gets the headshot. They go for the boost. Oh no, they're not going for the boost. Never mind. A2Z stuck back there with Fugly. Anger's left guessing. He knows where one is, but not where the other. Can he get this? Both members, actually, kind of low. And A2Z waiting for the push, gets it. And Liquid, just by the skin of their teeth, win that round.
Yeah, Fugly with the 4 HP peak, and he gets that instant headshot. That was an absolutely necessary shot. And he nails it, so that's going to be their first round here in the Terrace half. Luminosity went on a 5-round run there to start it off, so it's 13-8 now. And Liquid's got to keep this up, and they have 3 Molotovs to work with. This is something that we haven't seen either of these teams really utilize the Molotovs too much, aside from, you know, a couple... Luminosity did a couple executes with it over towards A and in mid, but... in terms of, like, an execute at B, we don't see these Molotovs being used consistently.
Alright, so, I mean, Liquid have to be a little salty with the last round, but either way, they still have that 5-round lead, and Flom looking to open it up here, takes down a Liege. I kind of miss Flom mopping, honestly. Peter filling in the shoes and taking up that role, but Flom, his rifle, it's still pretty on point.
Yeah, this is another round, though, where Liquid's going to start off a man down right off the bat. They're losing all the early battles, losing all the entries, so it's very tough for them to get momentum like this. And now Peter's got this advanced angle, and his A2Z going to be ready for it. He does flash. He jumps over the shot. It does leg him through a box down to 31 HP.
That's such a tough position to be in. And again, they're looking to set up for the execute onto A, setting up the smokes from Squeaky Entrance. And 40 seconds on the clock. They keep whittling it down, going for these... slow starting rounds and then just trying to burst out with a burst of energy.
Yeah, they hear this running now. So Peter's going to be a forklift with the AWP, but they have a third player over. It's going to be Flom right behind him. Peter's going to get a shot. He actually misses it. He misses a second one. Flom backs him up, but he eventually gets taken out. So it's Pith and Flom guarding this site. Pith gets taken out from above. Nitro jumps over. But now Flom, they line up for him. He gets a double. It's quickly down to just Adren, and he gets cleaned up as well. So Liquid can't take over the site fast enough, and Luminosity holds out, so a great defense, and that resets the economy.
I want to give props to Nitro, because that's the second time he's done that jump on a red box and just completely obliterated the A-hold, but this time, though, Luminosity were ready from Truck, from Speedway, and that was that round. The only thing is, Luminosity's money is hurting as well. You know, they're forced to rebuy quite a bit because of these executes from Liquid, but they're not too worried. 14-8.
Yeah, but they can afford to be in that situation up 6 rounds. I mean, it's brutal for Liquid. Look at this buy they have to come out with. 3 Tech 9s, P250, and an AK-47. And really, no nades to work with.
So what do we got? Peter still looking up towards boost. Liquid, again, moseying around towards the A site. Not much they're going to be able to do. Gotta take it slow. Gotta take it slow from the Liquid side. So Leech is going to be playing towards Squeaky, and there is an AK on Nitro. They really want to win these rounds. They know they're close to being shut out here. So Squeaky opens, Leech is going to lead the charge, and Molly comes out, and he finds the dink, and they trade it off a little bit. Pith getting a Dren. They're pushing into the site, flashbang out. They're trying to go for the plant. Yeah, he's going to stick it and get just shot out right there. So Peter gets the Nitro, and that might be it. That's probably lights out for Liquid.
It's going to be very much a similar buy, except this time they won't have the AK-47 on a Nitro. So yeah, down 15-8. Gonna have to come up with something magical even to keep prolonging this match.
I mean, it's full Tech Nines. There's that Tech Nine magic potential. I don't want to think that's going to be possible, but who knows? So, I don't even know where they can hit right now. Luminosity's holds just seem so damn strong. Like, you can't break their A, you can't break their B. And mid control by Flom and Lex. This time, Pith and Lex, though. Just working out too well. So, Peter, last three T's kind of sitting towards mid. And Fugly and Adren, it'd have to be a miracle play from them to make this work.
Yeah, and Adren is stuck in a corner that Pith seems to know exactly where he is, and he's going to get into that battle. This is the spray now, but pulls out a Tech 9 and cleans him up. Fugly with the 1 gig. A little bit of lifesteal. Can he get it through the smoke? He's looking for it. Oh, he does get it. As Pith comes running through.
Well, it doesn't really matter anyway. Fugly, left alone, 1-on-3? Maybe. Maybe can do
this. He's getting flanked out by Anger right now, and he's reloading, so Anger's just going to clean things up. He's going to end it quickly, so a very well-put-together match by Luminosity. They looked very good. They looked exceptional.